Today's topic is continuous chart distribution. Distribution of chart in different types of body, different configuration of body. First, volume chart distribution. Distribution of chart in three-dimensional configuration or in a volume. So this term is denoted by volume charge density. Volume charge density is defined as distribution of charge per unit volume. It means dq upon dv. dq is the small point charge at a point volume. So dq is equal to q, and value of volume of sphere 4 upon 3 pi r square, and the unit of this volume charge density coulomb upon meter square. Second, surface charge distribution. In surface charge density, surface charge density is defined as distribution of charge per unit area. It means sigma equal to dq upon dA. dq is the small charge and dA is the small surface area. So total charge is q and surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. And the unit of surface charge density is coulomb upon meter square. Third one, line charge distribution. Distribution of charge over a line, over a wire. So this is denoted by lambda. Lambda is equal to del q upon del s. Del q is the small charge at a particular line. So lambda is equal to q upon l. Q is total charge and l is the total length of wire. The unit of line charge density equal to coulomb upon meter. Okay. Next topic is electric field line. What is electric field line? Electric field lines are imaginary lines. This the electric field line denoted the direction or configuration of electric field. The property of magnetic field line, the first property is that the line of force, electric field line is also known as electric line of force. The electric field line of force are continuous curve without any break. It means electric field line is a continuous curve and they move without any break till infinity. But the density, but the intensity of electric field line decrease according to distance. Second, the lines of force start at positive charges and end at the negative charges. It means electric field line start from positive charge and end at negative charge. Electric field line start from positive charge and end at negative charge. They can't form closed loop. Electric field line can't make closed loop. Third property is that the tangent to a line of force at any point gives the direction of the electric field at that point. When we draw a tangent on electric field line like this, it is a electric field line And if we have to draw tangent this particular point P, Q, R, then EP is the direction of electric field at point P, EQ is the direction of electric field at point Q, and ER is the direction of electric field at point R. Third point is that no two lines of force can cross each other. Two electric field line never cross to each other, because if two magnetic field line cross each other, it means there is a two possible direction of electric field at that point, but it is impossible. At a particular point, there is only one direction of electric field. So, electric field line never cross each other. So, these are the property of electric field line. Next, electric field line for different charge conductors. First, electric field line due to a positive point charge. As you know, electric field line start from positive charge. So, due to the positive charge, the direction of electric field line is like this. Electric field line start from positive point charge. Electric field line due to negative point charge, as you know, electric field line end at negative charge. So direction of electric field line at negative point charge like this. Third one is field line of two equal and opposite point charge. It means for a dipole. So for a dipole, electric field line configuration is such that electric field line starts from positive charge and end at negative charge. And start from positive charge and end at negative charge. Okay. And fourth one is field line to equal charges. If there is two equal charges, then electric field line start from both charges, because charge is positive charge. So there is a repulsive force act between charge, so the there is a repulsion between electric field lines, and there is a neutral point between two given point charge if charges are equal in magnitude. Okay. And fifth point, field lines of a positively charged plane conductor. If we have a plane conductor, then the electric field lines are parallel to each other, and there is a uniform electric field.